Hey there, Benjamin from Love Starter here, welcome back. Today we're talking all about Squarespace and Google Analytics. If you're using Squarespace, then you need to install Google Analytics on your site. Yes, Squarespace does have its own analytics, which I love, but it's not the same as Google Analytics. You can't really drill down in the reports, and you can't link Squarespace Analytics with Google Ads, and you can't segment your data. So while Squarespace Analytics provides some great reports, they are basic. Before we get started, I want to give a shout out to Zootrix for sponsoring this video. If you haven't heard of them before, Zootrix provides a complete rank tracking suite to help you optimize your position in paid and organic search results. It can even notify you when your keywords move up or down. Okay, so we're going to cover four things in this video. These are different options and you can choose what works for you. I'm going to show you two different ways you can add Google Analytics to your Squarespace site. We'll look at the built-in Google Analytics integration. This is the quickest and easiest way to get up and running. And we'll also look at how we can install Google Analytics using Google Tag Manager. Apart from how to add the tracking code to your site, there are also two versions of Google Analytics. There's the new version, which is called Google Analytics 4 or GA4, and there's the previous version, which is called Universal Analytics. So I'll also show you how to install both versions, since lots of people are using GA4 and lots of people are using Universal Analytics. Okay, so let's head to Squarespace. To use the built-in Google Analytics integration, we need to select Settings. Scroll to the bottom, select Advanced, and then choose External API Keys. At the top, we can see the built-in option to add Google Analytics to our Squarespace site. To find our tracking ID, let's head to Google Analytics. After navigating to Admin, we need to select Property Settings in the center column. If you only see two columns, then you're using Google Analytics 4 or GA4. We'll cover how to install this version of Google Analytics in a moment. For now, let's select Property Settings. And now we need to copy the tracking ID at the top. Okay, let's head back to Squarespace. Now we can paste the tracking ID into Squarespace. And click Save. We've installed Google Analytics on our Squarespace site. So that's the simplest way to get up and running. But if you do want to install GA4 or you want more flexibility, then I recommend adding Google Tag Manager to install Google Analytics. The option we're about to look at uses the code injection feature in Squarespace. This means you will need to be on a business or a commerce plan for your Squarespace site. Let's head back to Squarespace to see this. We need to navigate to Settings. Then scroll to the bottom and select Advanced. Now we choose Code Injection. This lets us add code to all of the pages on our Squarespace site. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager to get our container code. I've already created a Google Tag Manager container, so I'm going to click on the container ID at the top. We can now copy the container code. If you're new to Google Tag Manager, then you can find links to my Google Tag Manager tutorials and course in the description below this video. Now that we've copied the code, let's head back to Squarespace. We can now paste the Google Tag Manager container code into the header section and click Save. Now that we've installed Google Tag Manager on Squarespace, it's time to configure our tags. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager. We need to add our tags to Google Tag Manager, and we also need to apply triggers to our tags. Triggers are used to control when your tags should or shouldn't fire on your website. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics UA. And let's select Tag Configuration. Now we're going to choose Universal Analytics as the tag type. We select the drop-down under Google Analytics Settings and choose the option to create a new variable. Let's name the variable Universal Analytics. And now we need to add our Google Analytics tracking ID. This is the same as the ID we looked at previously. Let's head back to Google Analytics to find it. After navigating to Admin, we choose Property Settings. And we need to copy the tracking ID at the top. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Let's paste our tracking ID into the variable and save it. Now we need to add a trigger to our tag, so let's select Triggering. We're going to select the All Pages trigger. This will mean that our tag is added to all of the pages on our Squarespace site. Now we can save the tag. Let's also add a GA4 Google Analytics 4 tag to our Squarespace site. To do this, let's create another tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4. And let's select Tag Configuration and choose GA4 Configuration as the tag type. We need to find the measurement ID for our GA4 property, so let's head back to Google Analytics. I'm going to open my GA4 property. If you're just getting started with GA4 and you'd like to learn more, then check out my other tutorials and course. I've included links in the description below this video. You'll find lots of great resources. Okay, so let's select Data Streams. I'm going to select my data stream. And on the top right corner, we can find our measurement ID. Let's copy this. And now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Let's paste our measurement ID into our tag. And now let's select Triggering and add the All Pages trigger to our tag. Now we can save our tag. We've now added both versions of Google Analytics to our Google Tag Manager container. So let's go ahead and click Preview. We can enter the URL of our Squarespace site and click Connect. Our website has loaded and we can now preview the tags that we added. Let's select the Tag Assistant tab. We can see both of our Google Analytics tags have fired. Now we need to head back to Google Tag Manager. And to publish our tags to our website, we need to click Submit. Name the version. And click Publish. The tags have now been published on our Squarespace site. If you're selling items on your Squarespace site, then using Google Tag Manager does have some limitations. You can add some extra code to Squarespace to capture some basic transaction details, but if you want to report on the individual products people are purchasing, then you'll need to use the built-in Google Analytics integration. Finally, I want to mention that if you're using the built-in integration, then please don't add the Universal Analytics tag to Google Tag Manager, since this will double count each of the pages people view on your site. And I would encourage you to only use one of the options we've covered, so either the built-in integration or Google Tag Manager and not both. This will help ensure you collect accurate information about your Squarespace site. Which option are you going to use to install Google Analytics on your Squarespace site? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thank you so much to Zootrix for sponsoring this video. I'll see you in the next video.